I, of course, do not think this will be a good year, 2022, for stocks. So it'll be a good year for people like you that get out of the way of stocks. And think about this, almost all risk assets, real estate, corporate bonds, you know, anything that goes up in good times is likely to go down. And of course, who's the epitome of this today? Who's like been the most popular lady of the last year? Kathy Woods at ARKK, ARK Fund. Stellar returns until February of this year. She's just not buying the tech stocks, the leading ones, as we all know. She's buying the up and coming ones, the more aggressive ones. Well, something I know that she doesn't in this case, at the late stages of a bubble or boom like this, it keeps gravitating. The dumb money is piling in and they buy the large cap leaders. And these stocks she's been picking just get overlooked, even though they do have potential. So I'm sorry for Kathy Woods. She's a great stock picker, but she doesn't understand the macro environment. She's seeing this as another correction. She's going to do the same thing, hold on to or buy more of the stocks she's had. These stocks are not coming back. And she is down. Now, I had to look this up. It was surprising to me. 46% in the mid-December at the worst, and still down near that now. She's not coming back, folks. So the ARK fund is not my recommendation. When we get in the next bull market, which will be years from now, yeah, probably no better than her, but I do feel for Kathy Woods. Great stock picker, bad timing now. So we've seen the succession of tops that continues to be the theme here. You know, all the way back to the corporate bond market, which usually peaks like a year and a half in advance. Well, right back to last June, 2020. And of course, we've seen this year, I mean, the ARK fund peaked in February. That's a great early indicator. The Russell 2000 in early November, November 8th. The NASDAQ on November 22nd peak. And now we've just seen a peak yesterday on the morning of the 30th of the S&P 500. And I've been telling my subscribers, this is probably the final peak. It hit 40, 809, I think it was yesterday morning. That's probably it. It's been down. I think that we're gonna open up January weak. Now, this is also, I'm biased on this, obviously. I do expect 2022 to be the worst year, top to bottom in stocks, the biggest overall fall in stocks of any year in history since the 1700s, okay, including 1930 and 31, you know, in 2008, the worst we've seen in recent decades and that sort of thing. Why? Simply because we've had three big danger zones in the last few decades, which I called all in bed, you know, 1980 into 82, that was the bottom of the demographic downturn after the baby boom, and the decennial cycle, first 3 years of every decade, okay? That hit, that was a terrible period, as should be, and the low lows that we haven't seen for a long time, so we'll not see probably since. And then, of course, 2007, which I telegraphed decades in advance, the peak of the baby boom, gigantic spending wave, and you'd expect 2 to 3 years down after that into 2010. Well, that went into early 2009 before the central banks blew us out of that. So they cut off that downturn early. Well, now this final downturn in the winter season should have been late 2019, early 2020, into late next year, 2022, and then the economy continues bad in 2023. Well, I think now we're gonna get 2022 in spades. We're gonna get double the crash in 2022 and then a hangover into 2023, maybe the end of 2023, and the economy doesn't come out till 2024 sometimes. So that's what I'm looking at. So this is a excellent, excellent, excellent time to get out. I gave the first sell signal for subscribers on December 8th. We've been very near that, and now I'm giving the final one yesterday and today, last chance, because I would not be surprised to see the first week of January down, particularly the third and fourth. The third and fourth is the last of the Santa Claus rally season, which is, some people say it's a few days before Christmas, but more formally the 27th, just after Christmas, through the first 2 days of the new year. Well, the Santa Claus rally has been up, but I'm expecting it to fail in those last few days. But most important, the first few days and the first week of January usually is a very good indicator of how the year is going to be. So I'm hoping the markets are down because I am damn near certain 2022 is going to be a down year, but this will be another confirmation of it. So I say now's the time to sell stocks you've been holding out on or other risk assets. This will be a really good time to look for updates from me. I'm going to be talking to my subscribers more, obviously, in the next couple of weeks, because this is going to be a critical transition if we are topping here, and I think high chances we are. So stay tuned.
Before we continue, help us clicking that YouTube like button and subscribe now to our channel. This shows the algorithm that you valued this information. And it helps us spread that message. Sharing is caring. And now, let's continue.
Do you want to know one thing about crypto? I made over 3,000% in profit in a few weeks. Fact is, the traditional financial system, the traditional money system makes you poor, not rich. If you want to earn $500,000, $1 million, you have to wait until you're 50, 60, 70 in the traditional financial system, and you probably will still be broke. And you will be old. This is not a sexy combination, as you can imagine. But the question is, how can you start in crypto and make these profits? Where to invest? Where to start? My name is Gunnar, and I'm from Germany, as you can hear, and things are a little bit different in Germany. More about that later on. Fact is, there are lots of different cryptocurrencies. It's a gigantic universe where beginners and professionals get easily lost. But there is light at the end of the tunnel. There are 7 key steps you need to follow to become successful in this market. You have to know them, and if you fail one of them, it's literally impossible to succeed in this market. Just an example, one of the key points is your exchange, and one of the biggest are, for example, Binance and Coinbase. These are trusted and well-established exchanges, but, and this is a big but, you won't find the super profitable coins on those exchanges. The unknown super profitable coins that get gigantic profits are not traded on those kind of exchanges. They are traded on much smaller insider platforms that are barely known. And I can tell you what those super secret exchanges are and why they are so profitable. And another super important thing are the right information sources. The point is, the internet is gigantic. There are hundreds and hundreds of YouTube channels, blogs, pages, and much, much more. And there are also market makers and influencers. For example, Elon Musk, he is not a crypto guy, but the moment he recommended Dogecoin, it went through the roof, to the moon, so to say. But why did he recommend it? Where did he hear it from? He didn't hear it from newspapers. And believe me, he is listening to someone. But you have to know who, and you have to react before he is reacting. This is really, really important. And these are only 2 of the 7 steps you have to follow in order to be successful in crypto. And if you want to know all of these steps in much more detail, and if you want to have a comprehensive checklist, here's what you should do. There is a link below this video. Click on this link and you will get the opportunity to subscribe to my channel. Click on the link and you will see a video where I explain the next steps. So see you soon. Click on the link now. I'll see you there.